So no-code and code can play really nicely together. They're actually one thing when you think about it, and it's just how we use them. So one of the top questions I get whenever I release a site is people ask, well, that site was built with code. Is that really a no-code site? You included some code in that, right? And my answer to that is basically, there's no such thing as a site that's built without code. Every site is built on code. And the beautiful part about no-code tools like Webflow is that it allows us to build code in a clean way where we're not having to think about the syntax or how to write it. We don't have to have a missing semicolon that breaks the whole site, but we still have to understand what the code is doing. And in my opinion, that's the hardest part, is understanding the logic behind why something does what it does, not necessarily how to write it or not write it. Those things can be easily looked up and found. So when we use code on top of no-code tools, it's really just expanding upon what the no-code tools have already taught us. We're able to use that same logic and just add a little bit more functionality onto it that maybe wasn't possible, or maybe it was possible and there's just a cleaner way to do it by using code. Sometimes using a little bit of code can save so much time. It's the fastest, cleanest way to do that. So why avoid it? It unlocks so much potential and so much power, and we can use no-code tools to speed up our workflows, to make things really fast, to where we can really spend all that extra time that we would have had on advanced interactions, functionality, and custom features that improve the user experience across the board. So no-code and code can play really nicely together. They're actually one thing when you think about it, and it's just how we use them. So you may be thinking, if I already know code, why should I use no-code tools? And I hear stories all the time of developers trying Webflow, loving it, and making it their primary platform. So no-code tools really speed up all the initial groundwork that we would have to do. Anything from setting up a database to setting up a form, these are all very tedious tasks that can be automated. And we rely on no-code tools when we do that. It really speeds up the workflow to where we're able to start building even better things on top of it. We're able to worry about the little details that really matter and invest time in those and into the functionality to make a better product. Another thing you may have heard is that using no-code tools sometimes leads to messy or unclean code. And I've tried a lot of no-code tools. Simple things like dragging in a div, I inspect the code, and all of a sudden there's all these settings and code that I didn't apply, like flexbox and margins, and I'm like, why is this on here? I just want a div with no styles. But when you drag a div into Webflow, or when you add a block of element, it's completely clean. There's not a single style in there till you apply it, and it's only the styles that you want there. You can add your own code on top of it to make things even more efficient, but the base of no-code tools like Webflow is completely clean and easy to use. So there's so many great resources for learning code. And for me personally, I used an app called Memo, and it's a free app that you can basically, it quizzes you on CSS, JavaScript. We're able to understand all the basics. Also developed a free course on YouTube called the jQuery course, where it goes through all the fundamentals of jQuery. No, jQuery is not dead. Webflow uses it. It's a super clean way to write code, and I highly recommend it if you're a Webflow designer to check it out. I've also learned from other jQuery courses on YouTube that were great resources. W3 Schools is another great resource for learning CSS. Anything you want to learn, you can go to Google, type it in, and there's going to be the best way or the cleanest way to write it will come up. Honestly though, the knowledge is out there. There's so many great places to learn. It's applying the knowledge that it becomes real to us. So I would just say, tackle some things that are maybe a little bit out of your comfort zone. Take on a project in Webflow. Maybe it's a passion project or something that you think, I don't know if I'll be able to do this. And once you start and you start looking it up, it's gonna challenge you to a point where you're gonna begin to learn, and that understanding is gonna become real to you more than any course or any other knowledge out there is when you're actually applying it. And the second thing I would say is find someone that can be your sounding board, that you can bounce ideas off of. I've been very fortunate at the agency I work for to work with a ton of great developers that anytime I have a question and I can go to them, share something, and that increases my knowledge so much more. It advances what would have taken me months to learn. I'm able to learn in a couple minutes. And there's nothing like having a great mentor that you can bounce ideas off of that will accelerate your learning so much faster.